Yoshi here.
And the MJ406.
Back for Ratchet and Clank.
Yay!
Unfortunately, not the good one, PlayStation 4, but hey, this is still good.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah.
The original had its faults, but it was still good for a reason.
Yeah, I guess now's a pretty good time to do it, though, and never considering all the Ratchet and Clank that's been going on. Jesus Christ, the movie, the game.
Yeah.
The death battle. Jack and Daxter.
Oh, the death battle was awesome.
That death battle, I gotta say, was actually one of the best ones that I've seen this season.
I know.
The death battle.
And of course, love the way they ended. They had to end it like that.
Yeah. And
oh, jeez.
Anyways, in the last part, we meant to plant Natalia, learn that Corvus complete prick.
Yeah, what a douche.
And now we gotta help the commando survive.
Yeah. Which reminds me, on the camera, I have all the, freaking, the skill point bulls. I have them saved as photos on my phone, so I don't have to look at them on the internet.
Good. Okay, so a couple of things happened while I was gone. One thing is good news. I've gotten all the gold weapons and all of the extras,
ooh,
as well as the rhino.
Ooh!
So in my later in my completed file, so we can go to the completed file in order to show that off, so I don't have to buy it.
Oh, good.
So I can so I could theoretically just buy all the weapons here and still show them off normally.
Yeah.
Which I might consider doing. The keyword is might.
Might, yeah. Cool.
There's still a couple of weapons I might. Okay, Mind Glove I won't buy. Taunter I won't buy. Glove of Doom I won't buy. However.
Ooh, Pyrocyter.
I will give the Pyrocyter some love.
Mm.
Basically a flamethrower.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it sounds like it's a flamethrower.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah! Now we can burn things to the ground.
Yes.
Oh, good! Our first victim! Burn to the ground! Burn to the ground! Oh, beautiful.
It's so beautiful.
So where are we again? We're in Battalia?
We're in Battalia.
Okay.
There is, I believe, one skill point or two skill points. No, there's two skill points here, I remember.
Three. Yeah. There's one about a grind rail section.
Yeah.
Jumper. There's one that's, destroying a Blargine ship with a turret.
That's the one that I'm thinking of. That's missable, by the way.
Yeah. Actually, it says this can be done anytime, not only during the initial turret segment. I guess you just have to go back there, eventually. Yeah. Plus, this is the remastered version. It doesn't specify, though. And the other one is, eat lead. Something having to do with the,
Oh, that one.
Destroying all tanks with the Sonic Summoner.
I won't be able to do that one just yet.
Okay.
Because...
You get that weapon later?
It's not that the weapon comes later, it's that the area is sectioned off where the rest of the tanks are.
Oh.
Because we need a gadget.
Okay,
it's not a weapon, but it's a gadget.
Right. Okay, so you get two for now. Ooh, a gold bolt.
Yeah. Yeah. Wall jump here to get a gold bolt. I didn't know how to get this for the longest time, but then I realized. Just wall jump.
There we go.
Okay, come in here.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
First pass over.
It's weird. For some reason this game won't expect you to be able to wall jump that much.
You think that.
And yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. I guess specific walls. Reminds me of Rayman 2 a little bit. No, that game only had like a few specific sections.
Ah. Here, gold mine.
Wow. Dang, that trippy lock was worth getting through.
Yep. Usually when the lock is complicated, they get blown up in the process, but they get a lot of bolts for it.
Yeah. I don't know if we were over. Do you get additional health later on in the game?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Well, what makes it annoying in this game in particular is that you gotta buy it.
Ugh.
So that's why I can probably buy one, maybe two if I want to skip a weapon.
Right, but weapons. Oh.
I think I did manage to beat Drek with only 5 hit points.
Yeah.
So, it's possible.
Yeah.
Anyways, in the meantime...
Yeah. By the way, I did see some of the skill point ones. I saw one that's like really hard towards the end, going commando.
That's actually not too bad.
Oh. Okay. Because
the thing is, there's a glitch in this game where pretty much you can leave the planet and come back, but the counter still stays.
Oh. Actually, the guy did say that.
Yeah, so really, that one isn't too bad.
Okay, yeah.
Let me get this ready.
Alright. Alright, this is where the first skill
point
is.
This is where the first skill point is.
Yeah, it says you want to go through this without taking damage.
Yeah. It can be annoying.
You can shoot the things there in the way.
Yeah.
You can. Oh, you can shoot her. Oh, those.
Those are the mines. The mines. They hit you. As well as mistiming your jump.
Right.
So, be careful.
Okay, yeah, now I can see where it's gonna get annoying.
Yeah.
Ugh.
It's not too bad so far.
Oh!
Like those big three patches of three right there. They are the big threat of this.
Yeah. Well, the guy did say, like, if you happen to fail, just get rid of as many mines you can and then do this again. Because apparently the mines don't regenerate.
Yes, yes, that's
unless you leave the planet. Of.
But hopefully I don't have to do that.
Yeah, hopefully. Oh, just a bolt flexion thing there. Ooh. Ugh. Going up the rail, that looks like me.
It's the camera angle that makes this really difficult
yeah.
to see.
Oh god, a wall! Oh god, another wall!
And a mine!
No! Oh, okay. No! Okay.
I think we're good.
Ugh.
Yep, yeah. We're good.
You just earned a skill point!
Halt! Who are you? What are you doing?
We are on a mission to save the galaxy.
That's right. Speaking Captain yourself, Quark is a villain. We have to take him down.
Well, at least that's what Ratchet wants to do.
Yeah.
Clank still wants to go after Dredger.
Oh, of course.
He's in the army to get money to go to college.
He's a true villain after all.
Yeah, money to go to college. That sounds like the story of our lives, right?
Well, sucks to be you.
I just want to get home to my family.
Yeah, no, my honey, I'm fighting for a government that probably wants to use us to expend money.
Give me some bolts for a bus fare.
That part is probably true.
Yeah. Oh, another infobot for 2,000 volts. So bitch.
Well, he needs to get my helmet.
There you go. Go to college or whatever. Make sure you get a good worthy degree. Oh.
Go to a good college before you. Go to community college. It saves you a lot of money.
Automated pilot helmet.
This helmet allows pilots to control our latest high-tech devices using only their thoughts. Please enjoy the demonstration. We still have a few minor adjustments to make.
No shit.
Oh, if they ever get the kinks worked out of that thing,
yeah,
that's an understatement, buddy.
One of those.
Death of the pilot is only a minor concern.
They may know where he
if the ship is fine and the pilot can die, we're cool then.
About wreck this, wreck that. I
think it's okay for all I care.
If you cannot see the importance of this situation, you do have problems.
Yeah?
Well, fuck you, Quark's an asshole, too!
You fell for Quark's stupid trick.
I would take both of them out. But Quark's easier.
Forget it.
Besides, I have no immediate reason to want to kill Trek yet. I have an immediate reason to kill Quark.
Yeah. Quark's been an asshole to me. Trek's just being a general asshole, but he hasn't fucked me over yet. Even though he is the one that told Quark to come after you.
So...
there is that, but we don't know
that
yet.
There is that.
We don't know that yet, though. So he's cool.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't blow up my plane.
Plus, there's also something. And plus, there's also another thing. Velen's still fine, so. Eh, there's no reason for him to go after Drek yet.
Yeah. Who knows? He could be a good guy. Maybe.
I like the I like how the reboot made, what's his name? Dr. Nefarious his, subordinate. I felt like so much more fitting.
Hmm. Oh yeah. Oh man, I haven't seen enough of that game. I just know it's like a reimagined remake of this game, pretty much.
Yeah.
Or at least the story of this.
I love that so much. How they did that.
They fixed the story to fix it to fit
it
better.
It feels so much more. Like, it makes it more sensible.
Yeah. Instead of Nefarious just showing up whenever he does.
No, it's like, you're supposed to just believe that Quark went after Nefarious in the past.
Oh.
And that's it. It's just like...
okay.
Yeah, he did, but it's like, he came back as a robot, and then it was just kind of like, just... it's just the way that it worked didn't come out very well.
Yeah. I can believe that.
Because, like, in this game, he's actually, like, Dr. Nefarious is a human. Like, and he's back
oh.
in his, he's still, like, in his, like, squishy form, as he likes to call it. His organic form before
of
he
course.
His organic form before he became a human.
Huh.
I mean a robot.
Huh.
So that's something to look forward to.
Shows how much I know about Ratchet and Clank.
Like I said, I've only played the first three games though, is the thing. Well, four.
Right.
Excuse me, sorry.
Yeah. We played All for One, which is like a side game.
A lot of people didn't like it. And again, I mean, it's like the purest.
It's not a traditional Ratchet and Clank game, but you know, if you want a multiplayer Ratchet and Clank game, it's a good time.
Yeah. I guess one day I still need to get that game along with...
It's a good beat-em-up, I can say that much.
The only one I'm really not looking forward to from what I heard is Nexus... No, Full Frontal Assault.
Yeah, I think it's Full Frontal Assault. I've heard Into the Nexus is short, but it's good.
Yeah, because from what I heard, like, Into the Nexus is like... It's a short game, but it, like if you like put that aside, it's actually too bad.
Yeah. Some people say it's like half of a game, but...
Yeah.
It's still
it's
good.
It's kind of like you're missing... Like, there's half of the game still there.
Yeah.
It's like in two separate games, though.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry if I'm messing around here. It's just that there's supposed to be a, No, it's on the other side. Okay, never mind. Now, as you can see... Tank!
Tank! Turns! The Devastator will be useful now.
Yep.
And a boom! What the... Well, at least I can't fight you now. Wow.
Exactly. That's why the Devastator is useful.
Yeah. I just know it's like one of the most, like... It's like one of the most useful weapons in the game. At least all around.
Yeah. There's plenty of things we're gonna have to do. But... Now I'm not as afraid to use weapons. For two reasons. One... Actually, more so just one reason. That's... weapon crates are everywhere, so I can just...
Yeah. I say, you're like full of Pyrocyter ammo already.
Yeah.
You're like half ammo when you first got it, and then it was like already full without
you
using
it. Yeah, Pyrocyter and Blaster ammo, I'm not too afraid to use.
Yeah.
Because A, they're both really good weapons, and B, they cost one each at the vendor.
Yeah.
Because it's a machine gun. And
yeah. Well, Devastator.
You get two, which is actually pretty nice considering how much they're worth.
Yeah, they're worth a lot. You can only carry 20.
Yeah, it's like 50 a round.
But you only want to use them when you really need them.
Yeah. Although, what's ridiculous is the Rhino.
Oh, of course.
No, because, like, I want you to take a guess at just how expensive you think a Rhino ammo is worth. Oh, god damn it.
Oh, what a dick. I'm gonna guess probably around, like, 4,000 bolts.
You are dead wrong, my friend.
More?
Less.
Oh, thank god. 1,000?
Less than the Devastator.
What?
20 bolts around.
Oh. Damn.
For the most broken weapon in the game.
Yeah. Well, I guess they figured you already paid enough for the weapon.
Yeah. It's broken.
Yeah. I mean, that's
the point. In the second game, I think it's like... I don't remember how much. I think it's a little bit more. But you can also find it in regular crates as well, the Rhino ammo.
Oh, good.
In this game, you can't find Rhino ammo
well,
in crates.
Well, of course. They want you to work
in
for
in the
it.
Second game, you can find Rhino ammo in crates.
The second one, they're like, okay, you already worked hard enough for the Rhino. We can at least give you ammo. This one, they're like, oh, you worked hard for the ammo, but you don't have to work that much more to keep supplying it. Only use it when you really need it.
In the third game... There's no supply for it, and the ammo is decently expensive. But the third game is actually not too bad, because it's easy to get money in that game.
I mean, of course.
In the meantime...
Stupid tank!
Toots!
Oh, yeah! I know the Rhino in this game is more like a gun, but in the All For One game, because everyone could use it, it was more like a suit.
I would understand why, because, you know...
Yeah.
The last one.
Oh, there he is.
Not chance.
Yeah. Damn. Ooh, you find that health.
I won't need to.
I love how his ears are always down when he's down on his last health.
He's like, I don't know how much.
Dude,
longer.
This sucks! I hate you, Quark! Ugh.
I'm gonna kill you, Quark, since I find your history.
He dies in the last word. Quark!
Fuck you, Quark! Okay. But anyways, speaking of which, yeah, I guess the first thing I can talk about is the death battle, which was awesome.
Oh, man.
I honestly didn't think that Ratchet was going to win, to be quite honest.
I did. I thought about
mostly
it.
Mostly because I didn't play much of a future series, so I didn't know he even had those, like, extra abilities, like Clank's abilities with the zonies to control time.
I just figured with the wide array of weapons they would have stuff to counter whatever Jack could do. And yes, I say Jack.
Yeah.
We know why. Oh god, it's this guy again.
Yep.
Never mind. Well, you tried. See ya.
Yep.
Okay,
oh,
course.
Oh god damn it, no.
Even if I have to throw you.
Why?
I only have one health!
Please, I'm gonna die.
Shaft leads to the turret platform.
Oh, now we're going to the turret.
Find a way to use that shaft.
I can't do it yet.
Ah.
Well, you'll see why. But basically, spoiler, we need a special gadget in order to be able to get into the city.
I see.
But for now, we get ourselves an info bot. I believe this is...
I'm off to find my battalion. Good luck.
We'll see.
Hello once again, fellow Blog. I hope this message finds you well. As many of you know, our home planet is no longer habitable. We've abandoned our factories, our laboratories, and our happy lives because of the encroaching pollution, leaving much behind. Fortunately, the nearby planets will supply us with all we need to create our new home, which is nearing completion. Once our scientists locate the ideal orbit, our new world will be perfect. So reserve your space now. Prime locations are filling up fast. Good day.
Dick. Now do you know, his head does kind of look like a dick. Stop him.
Until he has destroyed
everything. I'll tell you, like, huh. Well, I got bigger fish to fry. Even the color of the top. It didn't count.
Well, different fish anyway. Look, didn't that commando say we could get into
we'll
that
deal that later.
Yes. By using the we need another gadget. We're gonna get that in Orxon.
Fine. Let's get going. We'll come back later.
We won't need to. So we don't have to worry about it for now. We'll
be
back here for a moment.
Okay.
But anyways, yeah, back to Jack and Daxter. Jack and Daxter ratchet back up out. The reason I didn't think that they were gonna win is honestly like two things. One, the morph gun.
Yeah.
And just because of Jack's versatility and hand-to-hand combat and his vehicular skills. And I just think that Ratchet and Clank's arsenal, as big as it is, I'm like, I don't know how far they're gonna go deep. Are they gonna go deep, like, all the way with his? Because I feel like they went all the way with Jack and Daxter because they included stuff from all Lost Frontier.
Yeah.
With Ratchet and Clank, I'm like, are they gonna go like the whole distance and give all his weapons?
They went over at least most of the main games.
Yeah. But anyways.
Like the main like five or whatever it was. Basically not. Freaking all for one.
Full frontal assault.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's something that I always was like thinking about. But I gotta say, that battle was pretty awesome.
I know.
But I was pretty impressed actually. With Ratchet and Clank winning.
Yeah.
I didn't really mind who won, to be quite honest, just because they were both so badass.
Yeah. I mean, I figured they would win just because. Like I said,
the sheer size of their arsenal.
Yeah, I didn't play any of the games. I just knew their arsenal was pretty insane.
Yeah, I played the game, so I know their arsenal was huge. But I still didn't think that would be enough to take on Jack, just because Jack's power is just ridiculous.
Well, there's Clank. What Ratchet can't do, he has Clank for. And what Jax can't do, he's fucked.
Yeah.
He's just screwed. Because
Daxter's so incompetent. Well, he's not completely incompetent, but... He leaves a whole lot to be desired.
Yeah.
Alright. I mean, look at this. Look at this Clank.
Yeah.
The boss.
He can do everything.
I mean, hell, they didn't even go over the fact that he didn't... Like, he has giant form, for God's sake. And they didn't even include that.
Yeah. I mean, it would have just made him bigger, but... Well...
I mean, if they did that, then... I mean, I guess they would include Dark Daxter, maybe, and all the stuff that he did in Daxter.
They did Light, though. Oh, they did Light Jack.
But Light Jack was in Jack 3. So.
Yeah.
I can't wait till we get to the later games, though, especially in, like, Going Commando and Up Your Arsenal.
Yeah.
Because they make, like, references to each other.
Of course.
Because, like, this is where they start, because that's when they start making references to each other.
Yeah.